Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the adductor magnus muscle. Here we can see the adductor magnus muscle from a posterior view, and this muscle is divided into two parts. The way we can differentiate between those two parts is by using this gap in the muscle down here, just at the distal end of the femur, and medial to this gap, we're going to have a section of the muscle which is commonly referred to as the hamstring part of the adductor magnus. We've also got this section right here, which is more lateral to this gap in the muscle, and this section would be the adductor portion of the adductor magnus muscle. Moving on to the origin next, you can see we've swapped over to an anterior view, and we're looking slightly upwards at the skeleton as well. Now you can see the origin marked out here in red, and the adductor portion is going to be originating from the inferior pubic ramus and the ischial ramus, whereas the hamstring portion is going to be originating from the ischial tuberosity. And that's because the hamstring portion's muscle fibres are more vertically aligned, so they'll be coming down in this kind of a direction from that ischial tuberosity. Whereas the adductor portion, they're more horizontally aligned, so they'll be coming across more in this kind of a direction to connect onto the femur. Swapping back to a posterior view again, we can see the insertion of the adductor portion of the adductor magnus, and that's on the femur, specifically on the linea aspera, which comes down here, and then splits off onto the medial supracondylar line. We'll swap over to a different view so we can inspect that in a little bit more detail. So you can see a posterior view of the femur here, and you can see the linea aspera, which is a ridge which runs down the middle of the femur here, and that splits off into two other ridges which are directed towards the condyles of the femur, and you can see in between the two of them we've got the popliteal surface, which is a roughened area between the two supracondylar lines. So the insertion of the adductor portion is going to be on the medial supracondylar line and also on the linea aspera. Moving on to the hamstring portion of the adductor magnus next, you can see I've highlighted the insertion here in blue on the medial portion of the femur, just above the medial condyle, and this blue area is highlighting the adductor tubercle of the femur, which is going to be the insertion for the hamstring portion.
So we're back again with the skeletal model, let's take a look at the actions next. So our primary action is going to be adduction, and that's when the thigh moves back towards the midline of the body, just like that. And that's going to be the hamstring and the adductor portion of the muscle, which is able to contribute to that. Now, the adductor portion of the muscle is also going to be able to contribute to flexion of the hip joint, whereas the hamstring portion of the muscle is going to be able to contribute to extension. So the adductor portion, flexion, the hamstring portion, extension. So if you found the video helpful or you enjoyed it, you know which buttons to press. Press those buttons down there, really helps out our channel. Thank you very much for watching everyone. I'll see you all next time.